It's becoming an increasingly rare sight to see, but an exciting moment for those lucky enough to witness.
We've never had J-Pod out of the area for that long in this peak season.
More than 50 whales showed up, most from J-Pod, but others from K and L pods as well. These endangered whales were gone for a record-breaking 108 days. The Salish Sea is usually their home for the summer, but according to whale experts, that's been quickly changing.
We know for many decades that this was their core summer habitat, and the fact that they've shifted what they're doing so dramatically is definitely a cause for concern.
Shields says these mammals used to be seen on a daily basis during this time of year, but it's alarming to learn that's no longer the case.
Pretty much every year we're going, yet another new record being set with the whales not showing up.
Unlike humpback or gray whales who've evolved to go through periods of fasting, these ones are supposed to eat every day.
And yet these whales are going through long, long periods of starvation. And the reason for that is because the prey base is so erratic now. The salmon, the fish that these whales have evolved to eat over the millennia are patchy at best.
Experts say the whales looked healthy and well-fed, a positive sign of them adapting.
Short-term, hopefully they're finding enough to eat on the outer coast, hopefully able to encounter salmon returning to a wider geographic area. But if we want the southern residents to recover and we want them to return to the Salish Sea like they used to, it's going to be about recovering Fraser River Chinook salmon.
Some are pushing to reimagine how we fish, going back to more traditional and sustainable ways of fishing.
So when and where and how we fish needs to be taken into consideration in order to be able to leave more fish biomass in the water for these whales to find.
Other factors researchers say are leading to less and less salmon in the water, climate change, and the landslide in the Fraser River. But scientists aren't giving up hope, saying the salmon population can come back with proper management.